Black Black says he hates Super Gremlin. Yeah, he hates the song now. On top of what he said about the fake perk, he knew the perk was fake, but he ate it because he a gremlin. Look, he hate the fact that he said that, bro. He hate that he didn't want to put that out. Yeah. The man was taking, at his best, he was taking 100 perks a day. You know what I mean? When he got down, it was 40. I don't know how many he taking now. He clearly looked like he ain't even on drugs no more. He don't want nobody to be out there taking fake perks. He said if he would have been taking fake perks, bro, he would have been dead. Let's just put it out there like that. He regretted, bro. He regretted. So if you are taking perks like that and fake pills with anything mixed with fentanyl and all that type of shit, just stop it, bro. It ain't cool. You know what I mean? It was just a song. A lot of people don't realize that the song was a diss song against Jack Boy. Yeah. So he was in a fucked up headspace when he was even making the song. You know what I mean? Yeah. He was in a messed up headspace. You know what I mean? So he don't even like the song. So he go to Adam. You know, we all seen the Drink Champs interview when he was clearly blasted. You know what I mean? I don't know what he was on. We know what happened when he got pulled over and he had the white substance all over his face that they thought was coke, but they got it tested and it was really his medicine. Don't know how it got there. We seen that. We seen all that and we know what happened. But now here go Adam 22.
But I went lit like, bitch, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm always knowing what I'm doing. I remember everything. Shit a bitch could do. Ain't nothing get past me. That's when a bitch think you crazy, when you make all the sense. Well, a bitch can't run it on you. I never had a manager 10 years and shit. Still.
Okay, I got to say what I've said on other podcasts to you, which is basically from my mind as a person who's taken a lot of over the years, when I saw you like standing up suddenly in the middle of the interview and just kind of swaying back and forth, my brain, like the part of my brain that knows what it feels like to get up, was like, oh yeah, he's on a good one right there. And then I got somebody like Whack 100 screaming in my face telling me that I'm trying to stereotype you. So can we settle this once and for all?
That was so long ago, Rain, even they don't even remember that. Step by step, I can't even walk you back to that shit. So you had ask me something about that shit or something.
So that doesn't even like exist in your memory? You just kind of move past it as soon as you do it?
I do, but I can't walk you to it. Like, oh, this is what happened, and this is why I don't even really too much know what you're talking about. You say detail what?
Just where you were at during that interview, since so many people seem to have strong feelings about it.
I was alone, man, so you got to be more specific.
Well, yeah, I mean, usually if you get loaded, it'll last a good 2 hours, right?
I ain't came up here for you to like be playing detective.
I'm not trying to play detective. I just
examinator, nigga.
Okay, yeah. I was just figured I would bring that up since we've talked about that so many times. I figured you might want to set the record straight.
I ain't trying to exploit your. I ain't even came up here talking about your wife and that. Because I don't know her and I don't know you, family.
You a fan? We got the mold of her right there. You ever seen one of those before?
Yeah.
Y'all be kissing?
Yeah.
You can say we be kissing. Yeah. We've been married for a while. We've been together like 8 years.
You like, let me taste it.
Taste what? Oh, dear God.
Bring the man to the show while he clearly in recovery. Yeah. Doing better for himself, clearly in recovery. All he could do was ask Kodak Black about his drug use. How do you feel about this? Do you remember this? Do you remember? Look, Yak stood on all 10. You know what I mean? I ain't going to say he didn't. He stood on all 10. But to flip it around, he went ahead and threw out the lean of the plug situation. If you don't know, that's Adam's wife. They have threesomes. He publicly, only with black people. He only let her sleep with black people. Apparently, allegedly, she just loves BBC, so they make these porn tapes and they sell them to the whole world, let the whole world see these tapes. So while he going at Kodak Black about his drug use, you know, Kodak Black asked him about Lena the Plug. He laughed it off. He said, oh, do y'all kiss? The man said, of course we kiss. We're married. Look, Adam, you got to stop, bro. Yeah, you got to stop. Stop what? you go for the worst things. Like, you don't even just do the interviews. Like, Vlad give you a good interview, let the person talk and shit, but you clearly bring up questions that you think gone. Embarrass the interviewee. You know what I mean? You got to stop that shit, Adam. That shit ain't cool. You know what I mean? Let's start there. That shit ain't cool, Adam. I know what y'all gonna say. This dude looks like Little John. What's your music? I am Scars from the Playground, dude. All my music is under Chris Magic. KRISMADJICK. Go check that out. I just put out a new album, The Feelings of the Father. Yeah, The Feelings of the Father, bro. People say this person and this person rap better. I don't know about that. I don't know about that. I think you would second what you think once you hear my shit. You know what I mean? Yeah, ain't nobody doing it like that, bro. Yeah, man, I'm like a blast from the past, bro. Thank me later. But yeah, that's where the music at. That's where the music at. Back to Kodak Black, man. Adam and Adam 22. Adam, you gotta stop, bro. Interview people, do the interviews, and stop like bringing people up there just to make them uncomfortable so you can get some type of shock effect. You know what I mean? Come on. They traded seats. Kodak Black went over there and made Adam go sit with the sniper gang. Yeah. If you ain't see the interview, go check it out. You know what I mean? Everybody getting burnt out on Adam 22, bro. He just interviewed Pop Smoke Killer. A lot of people got a problem with that. Why? Because the man already got a life sentence. Yeah, he was only, 15 when he did it. So in California, he got 4 years. Said he don't regret a bit of it. They were just kids and it went out of, you know, it got out of hand. Look, a lot of people don't like that Adam 22 interviewed this guy, but for a minute, bro, they did, who was that? I forgot his name. The guy that killed all the people in Detroit, the old gangster. If you remember his name, man, put it in Nate Boone. They did Nate Boone, Nat Boone, whatever his name, Nate Boone from Detroit. He was bragging about chopping heads off bodies and all type of shit. You know what I mean? Terrence Gangster Williams, 40 bodies. Admittedly, he did 40 bodies and never went for headshots. Always, supposedly, allegedly, got them all in the legs. And I guess it hit arteries because he got 40 of them. I don't know, bro. But why is it different for Adam 22 to go interview this guy if y'all been interviewing killers? That's what y'all want. You know what I mean? That's what the people want, right? Yeah, don't select the politic on that type of on journalism. The man would have did a Fox interview or anything else. So I can't agree with that one. But I can say Adam 22 be reaching. He down with the gangs. He good. Walking through L.A., doing what he want to do. You know what I mean? Maybe it will come to an end one day. I don't know. But right now, Adam winning, bro. Adam ain't worried about shit. You know what I mean? Brick Baby done got choked up over there. Footage then came out. Brick Baby still getting money though. Shit. They ain't got DP yet, so y'all tell me, man. Y'all still rocking with No Jumper? Put it in the comments. Did Kodak Black handle himself well? Put that in the comments, man. Look, Scars from the Playground, bro. We ain't gonna stay on it too long. We just gotta touch on it. Shout out Kodak Black, man. You held it down, bro. You did obviously the best you could at that motherfucker, you know what I mean? So yeah, shout out Kodak Black, Adam 22, DJ Academics. Like, I don't know about you guys, you know what I mean? Yeah, I don't know about you guys, but y'all bring the entertainment, y'all bring the funny, so I can't knock y'all either. If y'all rocking with them, put that in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, Scars from the Playground, man.